The All India Council for Technical Education has announced that physics, chemistry and mathematics are now optional and not compulsory subjects for pursuing engineering. This move has given hope to many who perhaps for the fear of these subjects were wary of pursuing the course. Announcing the changes through its approval handbook, the council provides a list of 14 subjects including PCM that students can opt to get admission in engineering colleges. Times of India spoke to experts regarding this issue and the reactions were mixed.
All three subjects should be mandatory for getting, they should be prerequisites for getting admission into an engineering course. But there may be a question about what level of physics, what level of mathematics, that can be discussed. For instance, when we were admitted into engineering college in IIT Kharagpur, we had a certain level of physics, chemistry and mathematics.
Obviously, particularly, there are lots of students who are quite afraid of mathematics, particularly. And in the engineering entrance examination, joint entrance examination, either it may be the state board examination conducted by the different state agencies or conducted by different private institutes or universities or maybe conducted by this government of India, that is JEE Mains or JEE Advanced. Everywhere the different organizations and institutes are giving a lot of weightage on mathematics in particular, as well as the combined physics chemistry marks, that is called the PCM.
Nowadays, at the level of class 12, what they teach is much more. But recently, the government has decided to reduce the syllabus, and I'm not familiar with how much they have reduced, so I cannot comment on that. But that question can be debated. How much of physics, chemistry and mathematics? But it is for certain that physics, chemistry and mathematics, all three are foundational courses. They should be prerequisites for pre-engineering. Because physics has certain elements like Newtonian mechanics, which is the absolute basis for mechanical engineering and most engineering.
This particular proposal, which has been proposed, I personally think it's quite encouraging in the sense that it will just impose or it will provide a lot of flexibilities among the students, because a lot of students are aspiring to become the engineers, particularly generally. And they cannot just qualify because of this particular phobia in many cases in the mathematics, as well as in some cases in the physics, the physics and chemistry. So obviously that will remove that particular burden, no doubt, the particular obstacles. But obviously there are a lot of preparatory issues are also there, in the sense that a lot of students who are aspiring to become the engineer, they couldn't become the engineer only because of their weakness in the mathematics, but they might have a lot of innovative thoughts.
There is a subject for electricity in physics, electricity and magnetism. Without that, electrical engineering is impossible. So, chemistry, one can say how much of chemistry? Yes, for many engineering courses, not much of chemistry is required. But subjects like chemical engineering, metallurgy, and mineral engineering, such subjects, chemistry is important. But let me say one more thing, that presently there is a subject called biological sciences and biotechnology in various IITs and various engineering colleges. And they have made mathematics at the highest level mandatory for these people also, which I think is not correct. Pedagogically, it is not correct. And they are not required to learn biology at all, particularly for the IITs. Even without biology, just with the physics, chemistry and mathematics, they can be admitted. I don't think that is correct. For these people, biology should be compulsory. And maybe a low, very lower, much lower level of mathematics can be given to them.
Particularly being at Jadavpur University for last 30 years, I have encountered a lot of students who are not so strong in the mathematics or physics or maybe chemistry, but they are having a real innovative idea which can contribute to the national development. Nowadays, the government of India is giving a lot of emphasis on the innovation, you know, that innovation and startup, because we need to be self-reliant. That is the Atmanirbhar Bharat. So for that, definitely we need to be self-reliant. And for that, the government of India is giving a lot of emphasis on particularly the startup in innovation. And I personally feel that the startup and innovation, the concept, that particular innovative idea doesn't come based on the knowledge in mathematics or physics chemistry. It is generally inbuilt in one's mind or one's thought process. Collaborations with some international reputed institutes in USA or in Europe or in Australia or in Korea, everywhere they are giving a lot of flexibilities so that ultimately the students, the young generation can think, and the incipient ideas, those are there in their minds, it can blossom up freely. So, but we are imposing some embargo in the process of that particular competitive examinations or the scores they are securing in the maths, physics, chemistry, that is in the PCM basket. So it is a hindrance, no doubt. The conventional curriculum is definitely highly mathematics based, even in the chemical engineering department, from where actually my own subject of specialization. So there is a lot of component in the mathematics, physics, and the chemistry. So obviously there must be some bridge course for those students who are not having the PCM in their particular subject line. So for that, actually, definitely some basic criteria has to be fulfilled. So the course curriculum needs to be completely revamped.
This new provision of providing students opportunities to become more innovative as technocrats, as the government of India is giving a lot of emphasis on startups, the students need to be self-reliant, and that will fulfill the dream of Atmanirbhar Bharat. A TOI online report.